널 기다렸어.
We are back for the StarCraft II Star League 2016 Season 2. And this is going to be the second round robin of the day. Yep. We're now entering the nighttime. We got 14 more games for you guys.
So, yeah, that's right. I'm just making sure I got my tallies and stuff getting ready, because once we get towards the end, I'm going to have to do some like addition and subtraction. It's going to be really hard.
I don't know, man. You got to be careful about doing math on stream.
Well, no, it's going to be off stream. I'm talking about like when we get to those breaks, I'm going to be like, all right, well, let's like slow this down for a minute. But, yeah, right now TY is in the lead, 5-0. Number two is Cure at 3-3 with two away wins. And Bomber is number three at 3-2 with one away win. So that's the top three. Below that, Trap is in fourth place. Sue is in fifth place. And Hush is in sixth place currently with the current scores. So not like too crazy of results so far, but TY's dominance is like the coolest part of this group.
Yeah, TY's wrecking the group. Kier is doing all right. Take note that both Kier and Trap have played six games. The other guys have played five only. So they have one extra game under their belt. Trap getting that extra win right there in the 16th game. So not quite the halfway point, but
yeah,
close.
They got those extra games because of the team kill thing, you know, the Jyn Air special that they had at the beginning where they played their second round robin match before. But now we're going to match 17. We will have 14 matches to go before this night ends. And here's the scores I just told you guys. Wow, interesting that I would have actually thought Trap was ahead because he has two away wins, but I guess it's like equivalent to your loss score. That could also just be a mistake, but I was told earlier that it was wins and then aways, so I think Sue's actually ahead, but we'll take
They're tied for fourth, which is weird. Trap should be number four, and Sue
I guess
be
maybe we
five.
Only do, because look at this as well for Bomber and Cure, like maybe we only tally the aways at the very end.
After like win ratio, I suppose, it's not just about wins. That makes a bit more sense. So it's surprising to see Bomber at 3-2. Did not expect that coming in. Sue kind of lobbed him an underhand game. You know, just like, here, take this one as I throw my stuff into your base and you totally clean it up with no problem.
Ruins of Endion, man. It got dirty. I'm liking that map a lot, though. It's actually really fun. I'm trying to see if we're going to see it any more today. Scheduled to see it one more time today with Hush versus Bomber. So that's kind of the way
Hush picking things. That again. Except this time against Bomber and not Trap. So,
all right, TY, the god of Group A, 5-0. I remember there were like very few groups in the up and down matches where we had this round robin format where players would go 5-0. It happened occasionally, very rare though. And players that did not belong in Code A would go to the up and downs would end up doing that. And I think TY, again, does not belong in Challenge.
Yeah, he doesn't belong here. He was just in the finals against Zest. And, well, he did decently well there, too. Even though Zest won in the end and did outplay him over the course of the series, he still held his own in a finals in Korea. So he belongs up at the top. Here's Bomber. He's lost to TY, which is okay. And losing to Kira is not bad either. So this guy is actually doing pretty well against the other players in the group so far.
Yeah, very, very strong results. And he's just starting over. He's going to play against TY again. I would predict TY will win again, as he is not only 5-0 in this group, but also playing on his home map of Dust Towers. He chose this map for this matchup.
And this is going to be a fun one. Bomber trying to get his revenge. And this is TY's map, so we could see some away cheese. That's what I'd like to see coming into this one.
Me too. Looks like it's time to get it started. Dust Towers is the map. Let's go into set number 17 of 30.
Here we are on Dust Towers once again. And the Red Terran up in the top right. It is Bomber from the Afrika Freaks.
Actually, it's TY.
Oh. My bad. Okay. Oh, actually, that's DYE. Yeah. No. Yeah.
They switched the colors.
It's no all biggie. Good.
Here's Bomber, though, the bottom left in blue. He fixed his headset hair.
That's good news.
He always looks handsome, but like now he looks basically at his full potential of handsomeness. And let's see what's going to happen here. Like, I want to see a little bit more of that away cheese. So it's actually,
where's the two racks? Come on.
It's not a thing, but we're trying so hard to make it a thing.
I think we had two cheeses on away. I think.
Something like that.
There was one real away cheese. It was the first game we had where Trap went for the proxy robo on this map and then six gate all in with Immortals and Warp Prism. But I forget the other one. Oh, it was Sue. Sue did the away cheese.
He's done a few away cheeses, basically. I mean, that was the...
Against
was
Bomber.
The
what did he do on Invader against...
He did.
TY.
He did a Nidus attack that failed after he got behind.
Yeah, that's not really away cheese.
It's not really away cheese.
But the game against Bomber is definitely away cheese. We've had like two or three of these. Like it's a thing.
All right.
It's declared a thing.
Okay. I'll go with you on this. 3 out of 17. It's.
Yeah, I mean,
it's like 1 out of 5 games ish. A little bit less than that, but
20% of the time, that's a big chunk.
Well, just looking at. This game right now, it's like pretty even in openings. A much faster CC for Bomber. TY not building anything on that barracks, actually. Gonna go for a fast third CC, so okay.
Ooh, this get is the zoom in here. Mm.
Some home econ cheese. I'm like, some of your home ec class.
Some home macro play. Totally what we would expect for sure.
Well, this is just going to either pay off and get him massively ahead, or Bomber will have to punish. But if Bomber doesn't scout this, then there's no way to punish it. And that's why playing blind is not the way to go. And the Bomber will eventually scout that, maybe too late. Let's see what he builds off his factory here. He does have a reactor coming up. And his own third CC, look at that. So this is actually really good for TY because... Basically, Bomber is going to be hard-pressed to find damage with this opening. And also, he's going to have to lift it. It's delayed. Whereas TY can start mining from it directly before it's even finished morphing into an orbital. It's going to be an orbital fast. We're going to have that extra mining, saturation mm-hmm. from the third patch of minerals. Third set of minerals patches. I'm like, well, we're on game 17 here. But, this is... a really good opening from TY so far. Not that Bomber's opening is bad, but because he doesn't have information, TY is his greed is going to give him an edge.
Yeah, I mean, Bomber's making a Cyclone at this point. Pretty much going to be useless because there's nothing from TY coming across the map. I guess the Reaper, like he hardcore shuts down the Reaper here with his Cyclone, but obviously that's not very worth it. So TY getting even further ahead. Bomber committing to... not very worth units.
Yeah, not very worth at all.
Bring
the worth is low.
Bringing in the MOBA terms here, you got to mix it up. It's already game 17.
Yeah.
You're like, I never want to cast with you again.
I'm like, I cast a MOBA, like, everyone's like, it's a hero brawler! I'm like, oh, okay.
That's... that was a good... imitation of the community response or just, people who make a big deal of that kind of thing in general.
I played Dota 2 since the very beginning, and I'll tell you, this game is not a MOBA. This has last hits and items.
Dude, look at the middle of the map. TY's got 4 things on patrol.
Yeah, he's like, no, nothing gets by me. He's like, I wish I had the money to send a... 5th and 6th one to the top left mineral patch and the bottom right mineral patch just to be 100% sure, but I'll just scan you instead because I feel like that's a pretty good investment. Also, while I'm scanning, let me send a Reaper in and find even more out about what you're doing. Oh, you made a Cyclone? Lol. Here's some delayed mule timing.
Yeah, that's about it, all the scouting information he could ever need because he sees the 3rd CC, sees the Cyclone, he knows the build, and he scanned the main too, so he knows like what kind of production buildings are there as well.
All right, he's going to send out the new, more detailed scouters now. Like,
who are they?
Three Marines. I don't know. They're like, I guess they're like 5, 6, and 7 now, even though there's only 5 on the map until the Reaper died and one of the other ones went home. That's what I'll name them, I guess. But look at this. Like, the drop is going to go to his base undetected. If it is, it's going to take the longest path possible, which gives him further time to react. No ground-based army will catch him off guard either. And if you look at the army supplies, you can see that's the one thing that Bomber does have going for him ahead. Tua has even rushed out the upgrades a little bit faster. Well, double E-bays. Bomber already has the +1. But he's powering up more production facilities. So in a few minutes, if nothing changes in this game, suddenly TYA is going to jump ahead in supply. Oh, look at this.
Yeah.
And look, 7 beat Bomber's Marine. He's going to walk in the Cyclone and die, though.
Or whoa. Is he? Skirts around.
Oh, no, he's dead. I'm sorry. Oh, he's the most badass Marine of all time. He's like, no, I'll still take out 16 health of the Cyclone.
There's 4 Vikings to 3 right now in favor of TY. He's been consistently making these 4 Vikings. I assume that's the magic number for him, because the meta was always like you just need 1 more than your opponent. So sometimes it would be 2 against 1 or 3 against 2. So TY was like, no, I'll just make 4 early so I can win any fight. And 4 is a hard number to surmount, right? To remake enough Vikings to get above 4, you got to make 5.
Yeah, that's right.
That's like a lot of starport time.
Yeah, if you want to beat 4 Vikings, you will need 5 at least.
Exactly. And then eventually,
4.5 doesn't cut it. You need 5.
And someday, maybe next year, people will be making like 6 or 7 Vikings to start. Then I'll just go to Wings, Liberty, TBT. Everything is a circle.
Yeah, man.
It's the story of our life. Well, we got this drop coming out. Small little Marine of Bomber Zone. He took a page out of TY's book.
I think he's trying to bait some Vikings over here to deal with the medevacs, and he's going to try to deal with them with his own. Although he only brought 2 over, so never mind. Now, I mean, like, again, TY is going to start his 2-2 faster. He's late on the combat shields, but he actually doesn't... Actually, this is something I've noticed about TY's TUT in this group, is he doesn't get his combat shields early. He prefers getting his upgrades, spends his gas on that. Instead, he's like, combat shields are one of the fastest upgrades, and since we're not really fighting, clearly, it's not going to be that important. And he just saves it until later. He has a 4th base faster. He has the line of sight across the map. He's map hacking, basically. He has 2 sensor towers in his main base. And the Bomber's got sensor towers. Like, yeah, I wasn't even going to drop you anyways. I'm just going to get further ahead.
Well, here comes a drop, as you're saying that. But I doubt he'll commit unless he goes along the very low edge.
I think this is a distraction drop from the drop that's going to come from the top. So he's going to pull units back into the main base with this. And then a hit from the top side. Oh, this is interesting. Bomber's like splitting groups of Marines into all which ways, but they're all just going to die. I'm not entirely sure what the point was for that one.
Scouting Marines, making sure. And here come the tanks. A couple of Marines will go down, but the majority of them saved. And here comes the drop.
Yep, this is the one I was talking about. He still has the drop to the bottom right as well available. He hasn't used it yet. What in the world is... I don't even...
What?
He like just builds a... He builds a barracks there and rallies out Marines to be picked up by future medevacs to harass.
It's next level.
What is he going to build? Is that like real? Is that still over there? No, it was just a misclick.
By the way, TY flies his Vikings into turrets, and now the Vikings of Bomber come over.
Oh, this is smart. He's actually going to use the medevacs as tanks so they can win the Viking War. Ooh, one small mistake there.
Yep. And then the tanks, the real tanks, come over.
He's like trying to get that SMB so bad, but there's a medevac healing it. Oh, man. Bomber's about to get stuck in a bad spot, though. He needs to retreat. Here comes the huge tank army of TY. TY has +2/+2. Bomber does not yet. Oh, my God.
Bomber root commands in and takes a huge pummeling from those tanks.
The CC's still trying to delay it. Medivac keeps healing that SCV. It's not happening. I think TY could just crush that 4th base. He doesn't see it yet. He's about to, though. That one Viking just wants to be involved. Yeah, you're Viking. I don't want to be involved right now.
TY's actually supply blocked. Can't get to max just yet. But either way, he's got a massive position really, really nicely done. Tanks are going to drop in here all alone.
Oh, no, this is a bad idea. This is a bad idea. There's no support for those tanks. He's going to lose his planetary. At least he cancels it.
down it goes. And T.Y.'s had his fourth for a very long time.
T.Y.'s ahead in the upgrades. At it's 1-2 to 2-2, and he's got plus three on the way. He's not going to attack into this, although this is something that Bomber found success with earlier today, until T.Y. did finally shut him down.
Yep. Notice that T.Y.'s not actually making any more supply depots. He's just making more CCs. He's got that one there that's going to make it so he can max out. And he's just saving those extra 100 minerals, I suppose. It's really just clean play out of T.Y.
Yeah, you don't need those depots.
Yeah.
It's like just, it's another, it's like next level thinking.
Yeah. It's just like, you know, when you can't improve anything else, I guess you might as well just make one less supply depot than the guy who's making a mistake.
Yeah, I'm trying to think of like a real life example as to why you'd want to do this. It's like, okay, well, would you rather, if you need more toilet paper, do you want to just grab one roll every time you need it, or do you want to get the cheaper one at 12? That's like basically what we're seeing here.
Whoa, big group of Marines all alone out here from Bomber. And he's like a shark in the water. He's looking for blood.
He's going to have to stim again, but he has so many medevacs here. I don't think it'll be a problem. Looks like T.Y.'s in the fight. The Concave at the top of the ramp, and if you ever thought Concaves weren't powerful, look at how much that actually delayed this push. T.Y. has sent the rest of his units back.
And he's still having a hard time dealing with this, sending a bunch of his Marines back here. The tanks are left all alone.
I think he's hoping Bomber's going to walk into those, but Bomber's getting a good amount of damage done here, killing a lot of the expensive barracks, the long build times of those. Means, like, every unit he kills here is going to be harder to replace. Plus 3 attack is not done yet for T.Y., but it's getting closer. Okay, this is what he was hoping for, is a big move command in these tanks. Kills a lot of those Marines as a result. Plus 3 is done. A lot of these units get out. Can he get that one? No.
So a nice move by Bomber. That's one of the ways that he won his game. I forget who he's playing against. I think it's Bunny. But just another Terran on this map, just going for a big walk around with a bunch of Marines. Like, 6-7 medevacs worth.
Well, despite the fact that he killed a lot of those barracks, T.Y. is still basically maxed out. He's not replacing those, which is somewhat worrisome, but he has the money to. Planetary is going up, more reactors going up. Looks like he did replace, or, you know, added reactors on the new barracks back at home. Just not adding any barracks himself, like adding barracks themselves. Plus 2 finishing up for T.Y. to put him the same upgrades on tanks. He does have the armor, so he's 3-3 to 2-2 in just a second here when that finishes. About 15 seconds left to go on that. A great wall of T.Y. here holding down the fort.
It's red too, man. He's not messing around. Repping China here.
Oh god, this is a disastrous engage for Bomber. Tanks get caught here. Too many Marines, although with the SCBs over, I guess he makes it a decent trade. This is actually kind of crazy. And that's why some people don't like TBT.
GG. That's it, yeah.
He taps out.
It's too far along. His gambit did not work trying to go around the tanks. And T.Y. takes another win. He now sits at 6-0. And very much the favorite, as I said before, to get out of this group. Even if he goes 6-4, I think he gets out of this group. So there you have it. He's basically made his way in, forced his way in with 6 wins in a row. Now it's pretty much up to the other players here to fight for the second and third spots.
Yeah.
And Bomber taking that loss, it doesn't fare too well for him. He was at 3-2, but now he takes another loss here. Again, it is against T.Y., so it's not the worst thing in the world. You know, he's probably going to win against the players that he won against last time, as long as he's playing up to his potential, if he is the better player.
Yeah, I'm just trying to figure out if there's like an easy way for me to keep track of these scores. I guess I'm just going to do it in my head because I don't have enough time to write down, write down the losses and keep track of those as well. But yeah, I think that T.Y. gets out of this group easily. I'm trying to think of what score he would have to get out exactly. I'm just looking at the scores right now.
To get out, I think even with the 6-4, he's fine.
Yeah, especially because I think that actually just secured his spot. I think that 6-0 means that he gets out no matter what because no one else can. Three other people cannot beat that score. It's impossible for three other people to beat that score. Three people get out of the group.